conference over to Mr. Adhidev Chattopadhyay from ICICI Securities Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. On behalf of ICICI Securities, I'd like to welcome everyone today on the call. Today, from the management of Wonderla, we have with us Mr. Arun Chittilappilly, the Managing Director, and Mr. Satish Seshadri, the Chief Financial Officer. I would now like to hand over the call to the management for their opening remarks. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. This is Arun Chittilappilly. We welcome you to this conference call to discuss the fourth quarter results of the financial year 2021. Hope everyone continues to be safe, and I would like to start off by appreciating the relentless effort of various COVID warriors who made sure that people are safe during this pandemic. After reopening Bangalore and Kochi parks in November and December respectively, the calendar year 2021 started off on a good note for us, as Hyderabad Park also resumed operations on 9 January. All three of our parks were operational after a gap of more than 7 months. I would like to emphasize that our team was ready to immediately reopen the parks once the necessary clearances were received from the government. The team continues to excel with their dedication and resilience, as we found innovative ways to safely entertain nearly 4 lakh guests. Post-unlock, Wonderla continued to be a preferred destination for outdoor entertainment in our host city, and we witnessed substantial demand once our parks resumed operations. In January, our parks were operational only from Thursday to Sunday. This was further increased to Wednesday to Sunday in February, and in the month of March, all the parks were open all of the days of the week. Our attendance consistently improved every month since we first reopened the parks. Wonderla is also the first theme park chain in the country to be awarded the highly coveted COVESAFE certification by Bureau Veritas. Wonderla Bangalore and Kochi certified with Diamond certification, and Hyderabad Park has secured a Platinum certification. We introduced industry-leading safety standards and protocols to protect both our employees and our guests who come to and have a memorable day with us. This includes encouraging online reservation system for admission, touchless temperature and security screening, contactless transactions, and enhanced sanitization. Our outdoor venues have tremendous amount of open space, and our parks are naturally conducive to social distancing. Over the decades, Wonderla has faced many challenges, but FY 2021 was the toughest challenge faced not just by Wonderla, but the industry and the world at large. The results for the quarter and full year may not be comparable to a prior year because due to the pandemic limitations. Coming to our performance for Q4 FY 21, our focused on digital marketing and to use innovative approach, including influencer activities and PR campaigns, yielded good results. We recorded footfalls of 3.1 lakh visitors across all parks, which is more than 1 lakh per month. We also introduced innovative F&B and retail offerings in sync with the events during the quarter. On a YOY basis, our footfalls are at 77% of pre-pandemic Q4. We registered a gross revenue of 347.9 million, clocking a recovery of 77% of the rupees 449.1 million revenue registered in Q4 FY20. We are also EBITDA positive for Q4 FY21. The company's robust balance sheet continues to be debt-free and has ample liquidity of rupees 930 million. Even though there was a setback for us due to the second wave, and we closed our parks in April, our team is motivated and we are trying to put our best foot forward to drive the company to scale new heights. We have identified high performance and rewarded them with increments. Additionally, we are also working on vaccination efforts for all our staff. We continue to focus on sustainable value creation from our resilient business. Despite the recent lockdowns, we are optimistic that it will generate a widespread desire, which will help us drive attendance in the coming quarters. We are looking forward to put the worst of the pandemic behind us and delight our guests in our parks as and when the time is appropriate. We thank you for your continued support and remain confident in emerging stronger as our strategic plans remain intact. We can now proceed to Q&A. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. Participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one now. The first question is from the line of Sharma Kunal from Perfect Research. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening, sir. So I have a few questions, so I'm listening down together. The first, when do you see the India open up like a US where the post-sufficient vaccination, even masks are not required? And the second, sir, along with the opening of bigger park, shouldn't we also think an indoor entertainment option in malls due to two reasons? The first, setting up this big park in such a painful time, consuming a process and slow our growth. Second reason is that city people would be able to use in the city entertainment option more regularly versus coming once and twice to our big park. Third question, any learning from running Wonder Nursery and the Wonder Kitchen, which could help us scale up our business later? And the lastly,
can you please limit your questions to number two, because I will not be able to answer all of them otherwise.
There's a last question. Is there any opportunity to inorganic acquisition of the park in India? Thank you.
Sorry, I didn't hear the last one.
The last one is there any opportunity we see of inorganic acquisition of other parks in India?
So your first question was, when do we see the pandemic kind of receding?
Yeah,
that will only happen if at least 50% of the population is vaccinated, as you may already be aware. Now, in a large country like India, it could take 5 months, it could take 6 months, it could take 1 year, it could take two years. It's all up to the government. Let's hope for the best. They are saying that we will finish vaccination by December, but I highly doubt it. Maybe a year is what I think. Second question, what is it? Is about, could you repeat the second question?
But shouldn't we also think about the indoor entertainment?
Indoor entertainment, yeah. So indoor entertainment is a different format. It's not, does not come under the amusement park business. It's a completely different business, and the entry barrier for something like that is relatively low. Like you rightly said, the building a large park is always much more costly and time-consuming. But our expertise is in the large format parks, so we don't want to get into the small park business, because I don't think there are enough margins, and I don't think there are any players who have been really successful at it. So I'm not really bullish. I mean, I don't think it makes sense for this company. Third question, the last question was, could you repeat your last one? I forgot, there's too many questions.
Yeah.
Please limit the questions to number two next. Two questions, okay, next time.
Okay, sure. Any learning from the, running a Wonder Nursery and the Wonder Kitchen?
So Wonder Nursery and Kitchen and all was only for, it was only to engage our staff during the pandemic last year. Because we had an extended lockdown. Once we recovered from the lockdown and we were in a position to open the parks, we found it difficult to run both the businesses together. And also running a takeaway food outlet had its own challenges, because, it's a very low margin, high volume business. And we did not have enough. We couldn't recruit more staff to, grow that business. And at the same time, we were also trying to reopen the parks. So we have to take a call on, which we want. We obviously prioritize reopening of our parks and getting footfall ramp up over the other businesses. So those are continue to be there only as, we are not doing the Wonder Kitchen anymore, but Wonder Garden continues to be there, but it's a very low capex, very small operation. So we could come back and look at it again. There is a market opportunity, especially in the kitchen business. But right now, I think because we are constantly going in and out of lockdowns, we don't have the bandwidth to, you know, run both. So hope that answers.
Okay.
Your question is answered.
Actually, last one is remained. There is like opportunity. We see the inorganic acquisition over the past.
We are not looking at any inorganic acquisition right now.
Okay. Okay. No. Fair enough. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Rajesh Ranganathan from Doric Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for the opportunity. It's a tough time, so obviously you're doing the best you can. But could you please give us an update on our Chennai project? What is the current thought process around that? And secondly, we've tried different businesses, but within our own parks business, how have we used the time that we've had in terms of downtime to make it better when things open up?
So I think for us, the downtime is mostly we're using it for strategizing and trying to improve our businesses when we reopen. And I think that has helped us a lot, especially when we reopened during the, in the last quarter. We have also had a fundamental shift in our strategy in terms of how we market our parks to our visitors. So that has gone through a huge change, and we are much more digital heavy right now. But a lot of that work is still in progress, so it's still not a finished product. Maybe it will take us another year, to change in our marketing and customer experience to a fully digital system. So we are still working on that. So that those kind of works were going on. We are also revamping some of our offerings in terms of F&B outlets and things like that. So small upgradation works and those kind of things are going on right now.
So are you saying that, let's say, this 12 months or 18 months that we've had as a downtime, there isn't any significant project in terms of upskilling of employees or systems or rides, which normally we are not able to do in a running park, that we have used to, so that, you can wow your clients when they walk in next time?
Yeah, so that's what I said. We are working towards that. But it's more like a digital heavy. We are doing a digital transformation in the company in that sense. But yeah, it's still early days. It will probably take us a year or two to finish substantial parts of it.
And on Chennai, if you don't mind.
Chennai is right on hold because we are not able to start work on it. So it has been put on hold for at least till the end of this financial year.
But we have the land with us, or is that not yet?
Yeah. It is the land per land and some land development. Some basic work is going on, but nothing. We are not building the park as such right now.
Why is that? Is it because of lack of availability of labor, or what is the reason for that?
Yeah, we don't have labor. We are not able to move people there. Also, we have some outstanding disputes with the government in terms of tax holidays and things like that. So those kind of things have to be sorted. So we will announce whenever it's ready. So I don't see anything happening for the remainder of this year.
Okay. And on this tax dispute, how serious is it? How long is it likely to take to resolve? Because that's one of the growth drivers for you when things open up, right? If you're able to resolve.
Yeah, so I mean, we are asked for a tax holiday exemption from the local body tax in Chennai. I don't know whether you're aware, but Tamil Nadu is the only state which levies an extra tax on tickets. So we will not be able to build a large format park and run it with that tax in place. So they have categorically, agreed the previous government, but now the government has changed. So we'll have to work again and see how We don't know how long it will take.
Okay. And from point of view of, let's say, pre-COVID, we had a certain sales and a certain EBITDA. And let's say things do open up and we reach really 77% in fourth quarter. Maybe you can also comment on why when other businesses were able to reach 100%, maybe we had some peculiarities why we were not able to. But suppose we do reach 100% at some point, will our EBITDA be similar or better or lower? What do you think?
It will be better or at least the same as before once the COVID pandemic. The reason why we had only 77% footfall is because we were not allowed to open every day of the week initially when we opened. Only 1 month out of the 3 months, that is only in March, we all the three parks were open all days of the week. The other 2 months, you know, to some days we were open, some days we were not open, you know, because we had to limit the crowd also, right?
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Parimal Mithani from Credential Investment. Please go ahead.
Sir, thanks for the hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hello. Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. And this is for the first time I'm logging into your call. First, sir, is it safe to assume the last year will be the worst year in the company history going forward? The second question is, in terms of footfall,
can you repeat your first question? I couldn't hear you properly.
So there's a disturbance coming from your line, sir.
Now can you hear me properly, ma'am? Hello?
Yeah, it's still disturbed, but yes. I can hear you.
Any disturbance is there. I would request you to ask your question and then mute your line, sir.
Yeah, is it clear now?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So is it safe to assume the last year was the worst year in the company's history in terms of financial performance-wise? So it will be the base for the years going ahead, right? In terms of since the pandemic, it was the worst year. So we are assuming that way, right?
Yeah.
Oh, and second thing, sir, this footfall of 3.1 lakh, which you achieved in this last time of, I think you must be operation less than 3 months, and given the pandemic restrictions and all that, post India reaching critical vaccination drive, do you see this number to be surpass your prior expectations also?
Actually, I think 3.11 lakhs is a pretty good number. In fact, it kind of beat what we thought we would achieve also. We had pretty good footfalls in all the three parks. So I think there is a lot of latent demand. People are wanting to go out, but obviously because of the pandemic, there is a lot of restriction, lockdowns, all those things. So once the lockdowns, restrictions, all those things ease out, assuming that, you know, at least 60% of the population gets vaccinated, which you can already see in other countries happening now, I think the demand will be coming back strongly is what we think. And that is what we are seeing from other parks in other countries as well.
Status of the three parks as of 9th, they are still in the lockdown over. You can update us.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
What are status of the park? Are they in lockdown or there's partial opening of the park?
We are all locked down. All three of our parks are in a lockdown.
Okay, and sir, this footfall, was it because of the coupon discounts or anything, or it was just a latent demand which was there and people wanted to travel?
I think it's because of mostly because of latent demand, but we also had some discounts and some offerings and things like that. But mostly not discounted because our ARPU is also better than last quarter.
And sir, last question, if I'm seeing your company for next 3-4 years, in terms of how do you see yourself in terms of the company wise? I won't quote you to it. I just want to understand the business from how you plan to see. Given
Once the pandemic recedes, I think we will slowly get back onto our growth path again in terms of, you know, adding new locations to our portfolio, things like that. We are already working on it. Like, for example, we have Chennai and we have another project which we assigned in Bhubaneswar for a smaller, you know, like a small version of the park with the government there. But again, because of the pandemic, we've not been able to move. We have a couple more opportunities, one from Gujarat, and there is another opportunity from Colombo in Sri Lanka as well. We are evaluating all these options, and then whenever time is right, we will start working on these projects. And also our existing parks also, we are upgrading them slowly. And once we reopen, I think we'll be able to give our visitors a better experience.
Sorry, same ticket price range or like?
Sorry, I think you have run out of your question time.
Sir, if you can just comment, because I'm just logging for the first time, if you can give us a time, that's the thing. If you don't mind, I'll go ahead. Sir. If there's a problem, I'll log in.
Yeah, I've been told that only two questions per party.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Geeta Mehta from LHS Ventures. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. I only have one question. So recently, Gujarat government announced various incentives such as reduced electricity bills and property tax exemption for various multiplex and gyms. Can we expect something similar for park industry?
I think the Association of Parks are actively talking to different bodies. But I think Gujarat has always been very pro-industry, and they've been waiving some of those things. But I'm not seeing it as a countrywide initiative for other industries also. We are hopeful that some kind of exemptions or the tax breaks, or et cetera, might happen. But too early to comment.
So can we expect something similar in the other states as well?
Not sure. We are working on it, but at this point we can't comment on it.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. We would like to remind participants that you may press star 1 to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Meet Jagani from PS Associates. Please go ahead.
Hello. I have one question. How the current initiative of 50% office gain interaction, how's the response over there?
That's a new offer that we have just given, because we are currently locked down and we are not able to open the parks. But we are selling the tickets for a future date, it's a limited time offer, and I think we had pretty good response. I think we've sold about 7,000 odd tickets in about a week. So it's not a bad this thing.
Okay. And apart Chennai, are you looking at any other location? A solid plan of any other location are you looking currently?
We are looking at other states. Like I told you, I mentioned in the last answer. We are looking at a few opportunities in other states like Gujarat, Orissa, and... also, there we have an opportunity which has come up in Colombo and Sri Lanka as well. So we are evaluating few opportunities.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Participants, to ask a question, you may press star and one now. The next question is from the line of Nitin Dharmawat from Aurum Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. Just one question regarding Bhubaneswar, Odisha. The board is approved for setting up this park. You mentioned that you've not worked out details about it, but if something is there in terms of the kind of investment that you are looking for, because you mentioned that it's going to be a smaller format. So what is the kind of investment that you are looking for this, and what will be the timeline once the things open up?
It's very early stage. I mean, we want to do a very small format one, so it will be significantly lower investment compared to our existing parks. And also, for us, Orissa seems like a smaller market as well. So we are trying to tailor make something, working with the government there to see whether we can do a small park. They have been very supportive. They have actually, given us a lot of, they've actually been very proactive in terms of helping us with the land and approvals and all those things. So, but once the plans are finalized, we will be, we will update everyone about this. So right now, it's still in the drawing board.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Manoj Dua, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. So when you look for a new opportunity like Colombo or Gujarat, what are the parameters you look into? What are the conditions you think that can satisfy for opening of a new venture? Thank you.
We look at a few things. One is the area, whether there's a sufficient catchment area in terms of market size. We also look at whether the business can operate 365 days or is highly seasonal, depending on weather conditions. We also look at how proactive the government is in the state or area and how helpful they are. Then we also look at, how far or how close are they to our existing, projects, because we don't want to build two parks which are very close to each other because they may cannibalize each other. So there are a few parameters like that we look at.
And also infrastructure, sir. Water, electricity, connectivity.
Water connectivity, yeah, road connectivity, water, the basics like that as well, yes.
Okay. Now, if we want to see the company after 5-10 years, the growth parameters are opening new park or as per capita of India, where more and more people are company, more value addition of merchandise or maybe opening of resorts in our own park. If we are not able to open new park at the pace that we think and which has happened in the past, how far we can still grow from our own park? Can you give us some guidelines? Because new parks are because of some all conditions in the past, demand, USA, and the tax, and we are not able to open new parks. So how far we can grow from our these three parks in future?
I think our existing parks are still not saturated in terms of footfall, so that's something that we are looking at very seriously. Even if we don't add new parks, I think there is sufficient headroom for us to grow in our native market. For example, Hyderabad, we still haven't reached a million footfalls. Cochin used to have a million plus footfalls, and then it has dropped in the last 2-3 years. So we need to fix that. So some of those challenges we need to address as well. So, definitely there is scope for growth in our home market is what we feel, because our parks, even if we have a million footfalls, it's still a very small percentage of the total addressable population of each of those cities.
Okay, thank you, best of luck.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pawan from Lacuna Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for taking my question. Most of my questions are answered, but just one additional one is, what's the capacity, or you just mentioned that, for example, Hyderabad has 1 million kind of capacity. So what's the kind of operating capacity that we can think about when we look at the business?
Roughly, I think we can accommodate about 5,000 to 6,000 visitors in each of our parks per day. So you multiply that by 365 and you'll get the theoretical maximum capacity. But obviously, we may not hit that.
It's about 8,000 to 10,000 is the park capacity. We worked on a 50% capacity during the pandemic, which is 5,000 for the Bangalore and Kochi Park and 4,000 for the Hyderabad Park. So we can go up to 8,000 to 10,000 capacity.
Okay, so
I'm saying that's not sustainable every day to have that kind
every
of
day. It's not sustainable every day.
Right, you have more visitors on the weekend versus the weekdays, so you on an average out would be about 50%.
I would say, yeah, I would say you can take a 6,000 number per day, and then you can multiply that by 365, you'll get the number. Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. And second was, one of the previous participants asked about what do you look for in kind of expansion projects, or how do you think about capital allocation? When you're looking at these growth projects, what are the financial parameters you're looking for? Like, what are the ROEs or those kind of metrics are you looking at?
We don't look at ROE calculations. Are a byproduct of the what we have achieved, because it's not something that but we typically want each of our investments to kind of pay back within, 7-8 years. That's the way we look at it. ROE calculate, Satish may be able to answer this better.
Yeah, we look at the ROCE, we look at the payback, and we look at also first one is there a demand there, and then the business is there, footfall is one thing, and then we look at the ROCE and the payback also on this. But these are all long gestation projects, whatever we have taken till now, because the investment size is 300, 330 crores for Chennai project, for example. Okay, it has its own curve. Okay, when you talk about a Orissa project, the investments could be slightly lesser there. So we look into various factors, but you can't have a ROCE, ROE in the initial year. You build up the over the period, you have a better.
It will be harder in the initial years, and then it will get better as the footfalls improve, and the cost of the parks
come down. Let me rephrase the question. So 7 to 8 years is payback period, and break even you target about 3 years. Would that be fair to say, like your earlier projects?
Yeah.
Hyderabad project, for example, we had a break even in 3 years. EBITDA positive.
Okay. Got it. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Anuj from M3 Investment. Go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for this opportunity. My first question is, the Gujarat opportunity, I think, has been on anvil for some time, but we have not taken any...
So there's a disturbance coming from your line. Request you to mute your line so that the management can
answer
your question.
Yeah, I'm not just completing my question. Just on Gujarat, any particular reason why we are delaying it, or we have too much, our hands are full at the moment? So that's one question, number one.
Yeah, so I mean, we have just been talking to them, and there has been interest from the Ahmedabad government for us to set up a park, but it's still early days. We're still in the negotiating table on what to do, how to do it. These things are like that. It takes time for us to, finalize on a project.
Sure. All right. My second question is Colombo. Pardon me for my ignorance, but this name I've heard for the first time. Is it that we have got an invitation, or any more specifics on the Colombo opportunity?
Once we have, yeah, right now it's a very new, it's a new invitation that we've got to set up and run a park there. Once we have more clarity on that, we will definitely, keep all of you. But I'm just saying, I've just said it because that's the kind of, a lot of people do keep up, keep asking us to invest in new geographies and, build parks. Or take over existing parks. For example, the Colombo opportunity is for us to take over a semi-finished park and to complete it and then run it. So like that, there are different opportunities which keep coming from time to time. And so we will look at the suitability for our brand and whether it goes with our ethos, and then we take a decision.
Yeah, management contract types.
Sorry?
The management contract types.
Sure. And my third and my final question is, we have all three existing parks in a similar model. Bhubaneswar is slightly different in terms of leased land. But these are the two or three models we are looking at, or beyond that we are exploring. So management contract is something we have explored but not fructified till now. But just are these two or three models around, or we have something more in our...
I think mostly will be, we would like to build our own parks. That's the ideal situation, but that is very time consuming and slow in a country like India. So the other next best would be to, take over and run other parks for a management contract. So that also we are exploring. We have a few opportunities. In fact, we have at least 4 or 5 opportunities like that in India. And we have this opportunity has just come from Colombo as well, and many other countries. But we are just restricting ourselves to the Indian, subcontinent for now.
Okay. So if you permit me one more, what is the key reason we are being slow in taking off? Because I think these opportunities in management contract have been there for some time. Is it the financial consideration, or is it our inability to visualize how parks will be? What is delaying? So I understand one in Bombay, which you have clearly said it's out of consideration, but others, what could be the reasons?
Different parks have different issues, because usually when they come to us, maybe it's a half finished project, maybe some projects have run out of money, maybe some projects were planned but nobody, it never took off. So there are various reasons for why various projects don't take off properly. So we have to assess it and then see whether we want to jump into it. So we usually take our own time with it because we don't want to hurry into something like this because it's a long-term commitment.
Sure. Really appreciate it. Thank you for the answers.
Yeah.
Thank you. We would like to remind participants that you may press star 1 to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Saurabh Arora. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. I have two questions. Number one is, most of the corporate companies have extended work from home culture for their employees, and they are saying it a great opportunity for post-COVID as well. How do you think this would affect our business in Bangalore and Hyderabad, as these are top locations for such corporate companies?
I think work from home, I think it's here to stay in some form. Even I'm working from home for the last year or so. So I think there is some comfort in that. But at the same time, I think, that cannot go on forever. Maybe for a tech-related company, it makes more sense to do it. But a company like us, we will definitely, we have parks and we run them and it's a physical infrastructure. So remote working may not, but will it, I think it will be better for us because people, it would definitely decongest some of our cities. Traffic might, traffic times will improve and, I think people will find it easier to commute, which is always a good thing for a company like us. Ease of commute is one of the main factors that decide how many people come to a park.
Employees of corporate companies, private tech companies, may be huge customer base for our parks too, if they are not in Bangalore and Hyderabad.
Just because they work from home doesn't mean that they'll never go out of their house, right?
Yeah, but they will work from other states in their hometowns, like Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi.
But that is, that's not going to be, I don't see the populations of our cities going down. As long as our cities are thriving and the populations of our cities are growing, I think we'll also be growing.
Okay, my second question is, in last phone calls, you discussed about salary cuts as cost-cutting measure. I want to ask, what was such cuts in case of directors? What the remuneration and commissions director received during FY21?
You will see more of it on the annual report, please. Hello?
Sorry, pardon?
Those disclosures, you will see more of it in the annual reports.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, sir.
The next question is from the line of Rajesh Ranganathan from Doric Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for this opportunity again. So, through this pandemic and even before that, things were slow in India. So we've lost some top management, I guess, some voluntarily, some otherwise. What's our plan going ahead in terms of how do we recruit and retain talent, given how difficult the industry is right now?
I think the difficulty in the industry is there everywhere right now, and I don't think it's unique to our industry. I think it's there for, I would say, at least 40-50% of the businesses in India or anywhere in the world suffering right now. So it's not unique to us. So, and I don't think it's not a perennial problem. It's going to go away at some point. We don't know when. So we are just getting ready for that day when we feel like we can open the parks and welcome visitors. So whatever changes and improvements to our product and service that we can do, we are doing it now. So that's the way we look at it. We continue to hire people, especially in the digital and marketing fields, because we feel that that is the area where there's maximum change happening, as you are all aware. So we continue to hire people. And so that's an ongoing process. I don't think that will be impacted because of the pandemic.
Okay. For my second question, you had mentioned a few times already that one of the things you're focusing on is a digital transformation of the firm. Could you give us some specific examples on what are the most impactful projects on this? Because you look at many
mostly to do with, I mean, we will start off with something like marketing automation, which I think we need to, it's overdue for us, we need to do that. So we are working on that, automating our whole marketing system. And consequently, what happens with that is also how we interact with our customer in the parks. A lot of that can be digitized, knowing our customer better, like how often is somebody coming to the park? Is there an opportunity for me to, you know, give offers to him? We're already doing it, but we have just started doing it. So I think in a year and a half, I think we'll have that completed. It's still in a work in progress right now.
So one of the areas, say, globally people have worked on is something you mentioned in terms of digitally interacting with the visitors when they are in the park,
yes,
or even when they are about to enter the park or
after. That's what I'm saying, park. Yeah. So there are 2-3 aspects. One is the whole marketing aspect of it. Then the other is the whole customer aspect, customer service or, customer interaction part of it. That also can be digitized. And also the customer life cycle, like whether how do we make sure that people come back to us at a certain point? Can we give them sweetening deals or, how can we stay relevant in their lives even after they come and visit us and, you know, reduce the lag between one visit and the next. So a lot of things are available in that whole realm. Amusement park industry generally has been a little slow, even internationally, to embrace the whole digital culture because it is expensive to do in an amusement park because digitizing a park is also an expensive process. So we are looking into that. But we will, once the plans are more final, we will be sharing with everyone.
Okay. But this doesn't include digitizing the ride itself, right? You're not looking at digital rides or digital experiences in terms of
that also will be part of it for sure. Having virtual rides.
But at this stage, you're not able to share anything.
Yeah, no, we can't. I mean, still, we've just started work on that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. We would like to remind participants that you may press *1 to ask a question. The next question is from the line of Adidev Chattopadhyay from ICICI Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. Just a housekeeping question. What is the breakup of ticketing and non-ticketing revenue for the quarter? And on that, on our F&B pricing strategy, how are we looking to get customers to spend more on that whenever parks are open? Thank you.
I think this quarter we had about 75-25. 75% was ticket and 25% non-ticket, which is higher than what we used to have in Q4 in previous years. The reason for that is we had higher percentage of retail footfalls as against group footfalls. Like pre-COVID, we used to get a lot of schools and colleges during Jan, February and March. But in this last Jan, February and March, we got mostly retail footfalls, people who came, bought the tickets directly from us and came to the park. Now, because of that, they are higher spending people. They are higher, propensity to spend is higher, and that is why our non-ticket revenue is better. I think Satish can maybe add something to that.
Yes, sir. I think you have covered it very well.
Okay. And as I said, when things eventually get back to normal, how are we looking at that? If we get back to where it was pre-COVID, the rough breakup, or is there some strategic shift you see to get the margins up in terms of getting more out of the F&B business?
I think our strategy is definitely to improve our non-ticket spend, because I think non-ticket revenue is something that we can, going back to the whole digital transformation part of it, is something that goes very well with that also. We will be able to sell, upsell and cross-sell F&B and merchandise to our customers better once we have those opportunities. We're already doing it, but it's such a very, we are at 75-25, but we want to obviously bring non-ticket revenue to at least about 30%, 30-35%.
Okay. And just a second question, when obviously the parks eventually reopen, hopefully pretty soon, Do you expect the number of rides you can open, like something similar to the trajectory which happened last year? Like the water rides may not be active and they may get active later.
Yeah, I think, yeah, it's hard to predict how it will be, but they could be, you know, every district and every state has a different way of handling this. So some states, they will allow you to open the water park first. Some people, some states, they don't allow you to do it. So I think it's a bit of a mess. But eventually they do allow all aspects of the rides to be opened.
Okay. And if I just squeeze in a last question on the salaries, and last year we had taken some pay cuts, obviously, during the shutdown period. So this year, are we now again looking at a fresh round of salary cuts, or are we like reinstated the salaries and plan to continue with that?
We had reinstated salaries, you know, whenever we were open, and we especially open every day, and, you know, people had to come to work and things like that. But during the lockdown, there is a salary cut again, not as deep as what we did last year. But we are definitely looking at some salary cuts so that we can, you know, maintain our cash flows.
Okay.
So there is certainly some cost rationalization, but we don't anticipate the lockdown period extended like last year. You know, last year we had about 7 to 8 months closed, park closed. We don't expect that type of a long lockdown on account of second wave. Okay, there will be cost rationalization throughout.
Yeah, so just on that, so I think last year it was around 4 crores a month, right, was our running cost, if I believe, when the park.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So it would be at similar
levels. On the lockdown time, yeah.
So this would be slightly.
We'll have similar levels. We'll have somewhere similar levels would be having.
Okay, fine. Yeah, that's very helpful. That's it from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Manoj Dua, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Sir, is it possible, can we have monthly breakdown of sales in this quarter?
Sadish, you
want that, sir? No, we give our results on quarterly, but what do you want to know, the footfalls or what exactly you want to know?
Anything, yeah. I want to understand how...
These are all very, you know... These are all very working figures, and whether we want to go to that details.
No, I actually want to understand the market.
You can send it to him later on.
Yeah, you can. We can share it with you separately.
Okay, thank you. That's your question.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, this was the last question for today. I would now like to hand the conference over to Mr. Adhidev Chattopadhyay from ICICI Securities for closing comments.
Yeah, thank you everyone for joining us on the call today. I'd like to hand it back to the management for their closing remarks.
Thank you all for attending the Wonderla Holidays Q4 FY21 result update. All of you, please stay safe and take care, and we'll see you soon. Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of ICICI Securities Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines.